Hello, I'm Gavin Howie, and today we're going to be looking at the vanishing point filter. But before we go to the filter itself, let's have a look at one of the reasons you'd want to use it. What I've got on screen here is a picture that has great converging verticals, a real sense of distance and depth. Trouble is, I've got this sign right at the bottom, and I really don't like that. So let's zoom in nice and tight on the sign, and think about getting rid of it. What are we going to use? Let's go with a clone tool. So let's just clone this out by selecting some boards from here, and then we'll just pop them over the top of the sign and it disappears. Easy. Trouble is, the boards we're adding in are noticeably smaller than the boards next to them. As a result, it doesn't really look right. Now, in reality, of course, all these boards are the same size, but because Photoshop is a two-dimensional program, it doesn't know that and it just sees what you see on screen. So vanishing point can turn your two-dimensional image into a three-dimensional model. Okay, let's undo that and have a look at the vanishing point filter itself, which is under filter and vanishing point. Now, the first thing you need to do when you come into vanishing point is to define a plane. Now, I'm not talking about the things with wings and propellers that takes you on holiday every year. I'm talking about a flat surface. Now, your surface could be horizontal, it could be vertical. In my case, it's this boardwalk here. And you define a plane by clicking its four visible corners. So let's click here and come across, and then we'll come up to the edge of my boardwalk as much as I can see, like so. Now, planes come in a couple of different colours. The colour you're looking to see is blue, but if you have a yellow one or a red one, then you may need to try defining your plane again. You can change things around, so if it's not spot on, you can always drag the corner nodes, like so. You can see yellow, bad colour, blue, good colour. If it's not big enough, like ours isn't here, you can also drag the middle nodes. You can drag them in and out, like so. And of course, you can fine-tune your plane at any point. Just make sure it all works. There we go, nice and neatly, all the way down. Now let's get the zoom tool and we'll just zoom in over this area here that we want to remove, because vanishing point comes with a handy little tool that'll look very familiar to you. Yes, it's the clone stamp tool, but it's not quite the same as the clone stamp tool in your ordinary Photoshop. Now, first of all, it works in the same way. You have to hold the Alt button on the keyboard and click an area that's undamaged, such as here. Now, first thing you'd notice is that the brush isn't a brush shape. It's actually a picture. So it is a little bit different, a little bit better, I think, than the ordinary clone tool inside of Photoshop. Also, you'll notice that my clone tool matches the board here and here and all the way up here. And no matter where I put it, this tool changes size and shape to fit in with the plane of your image. So if I clone here like so, my new boards are exactly the right size. Now, this is why defining the plane was so important, and it makes life so much quicker and easier. There you go, and it's gone. It was as quick as that. Fantastic. Now, whilst we're here, we might as well have a look at a few other areas as well. There's a bit down here I can see where we've got a bit of rubbish, and we can use the same tool, the clone tool, and again, we can define a new point by holding Alt on the keyboard, clicking an undamaged area, and then just pasting it in. Now, you'll notice that my brush becomes more squashed the further down the plane I go. That's because, of course, my brush, like the boards on the boardwalk, is getting further and further away from the source point from us, and therefore becomes smaller and more squashed. It actually changes the perspective of the brush to make this job a lot easier. There we go, and there's a bit there. You can change the brush size using the little options up here, like that. And if you want to, you can even have the healing brush as well. So if you want it to make new pixels, you can do that too. So the brush itself is very, very versatile and works just as well as your clone tool, but with the added bonus that it matches your three-dimensional model, your plane, and fills in the gaps correctly sized. Okay, there you go. We'll just click OK. And we've now completely cleaned up our picture. It only took a few clicks and it looks fantastic.